Hey, it's Fran, again at the bench, with part two on these little incandescent light pipe displays. The last video I discombobulated this display, and rather than trying to tinker out the multiplexed logic driver module, I've basically just taken this display and I've hardwired it to my own driver module back here, which is being controlled with my BCD real-time clock. And I've shown this many, many times. This was a project back from the 1.0 lab, but I've got the BCD output and also real 1 second pulse and cool Numatron right there. And I've got a 7447 chip there with running a bank of 3904s. And I know people are going to say, Fran, why don't you just run it right from the chip? Well, this is a universal driver board, so I can drive just about anything. And I've got a 5 volt bus running this little incandescent display. And it's a lot more yellow from where I'm standing, especially if you look at it sort of obliquely. Yeah, from the side you can sort of see the more incandescent look on those light pipes there, all those individual fibers. So yeah, I mean, where I'm standing, it's very kind of yellow. I'm running it at the full 5 volts, and I wanted to find out how much this display would pull when it's full voltage. So I've got an ammeter hooked up. I'm going to hold it here at 8. And holding the 8, we see it's 148 milliamps. Yep, so divided by 8. 8 because I've got the decimal illuminated. So, yeah, so 18.5 milliamps per bulb. So, the regular driver chip, it'll sync up to like 40 milliamps. So it's only going about halfway there, not even halfway. It's going to run this a little while and see how warm it gets. But yeah, these bulbs, it's a little, the bezel's getting a little warm, but it's just amazing that they were able to make these tiny little micro incandescents that would run on so little current that you could easily switch them with just a regular TTL logic. Pretty amazing, and fairly bright. I mean, the thing about this display, because of the way the light pipes are, when you look at it edge on, if you're 45 degree angle, it's very readable, but it's not nearly as bright. So at a side angle, it's readable, certainly more readable than Nixie tubes are at oblique angles like this, but the brightness drops off exponentially. But straight on, you could probably read that in the daylight. It'd be a little dim, but if you're looking at it straight on, you'd probably be able to read the number against the black background. Not much more to say about this, except that, I thought that you'd get a kick out of looking at it running. And, so there you go. Well, thanks for watching. Thanks to all the patrons for making all these videos possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Everybody on Patreon. This was a short one, but I thought it was pretty cool. Alright, I'll be back here at the bench doing something else real soon. Bye! Berserk in my lab, it's where I work.
what you're watching. Friend, it's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again. I'm Fran.